We're getting audio through here though, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That works. And then. I think that's what I'm going to have to do. Yeah. I think we're good.
Okay,
all right.
Cool.
Are we good here? We're good here. Excellent. All right, everyone. So we are Team HOPE, the Hurricane Operations Platform for Emergencies, just to go to show that just like our government, we can also come up with creative acronyms. Obviously, time and being the key here, right? You think about Hurricane Ian and its recent impact. Thankfully, not as much to the Tampa Bay area. Unfortunately, not so much for everyone else, right? So recent research that Tahmina did, we had, we're up to over 100 deaths and an estimate of about $60 billion in damages, right? And hurricanes, just generally speaking, whether we're talking about Harvey, Katrina, any of them, you know, still, even in this age where we've got forecasting and capabilities, there's still a tremendous source of death and destruction. So we started looking at it and said, how could we do things better with what we had, right? We took a look across two different axes, right? Time and how can we optimize, right? So there's three key events. We talk about a hurricane. You know, there's before, there's during, there's after, right? And so what we wanted to use was the technology stack that we have. We'll talk about that in a little bit and look at some of the things that would happen in a major event like this, right? So before, I need to evacuate. Where do I go, right? I need to maybe connect up. I need to have people be able to find out where I am. Understanding, of course, that when a hurricane comes through, infrastructures are usually taxed, whether it's because they're outright leveled or it's because a lot of people are trying to make use of that infrastructure, right? Everybody's trying to make a call at once. Guess what? Nobody's calls go through. After a hurricane, just basic necessities. Hey, I stuck around, but we've got no power. We've got no water in our area, right? And that information can be useful to all sorts of emergency providers. So we kind of see three big areas that we made use of with the Jambonz API. There's a mass alert system, right? So the ability to push information out. There's real-time statistics. I can grab information as people are putting this into the system. And then custom callback feature. We hope to show a couple of those today. Although understanding, of course, that they're live demos. So keep our fingers crossed and we will hope that stuff works the way it's supposed to. Thank you very much. Anyway. So mass alert system, right? Hey, an evacuation order gets put out there, right? HOPE dials out. It sends out an automated message to the people who have registered and are starting to use the system. So we've got a very nifty, very brief front end that we've built here, right? So again, this is more on the server side, less, you know, this is not a user doing this. It's just so we have something to actually demonstrate. But we'll go ahead and notify users, right? And what we should happen should be happening is we get a call coming in, right? Can I have that mic?
Yes, you can.
Right, so I've got a call coming in. Hello? That was brief and bright, right? Your evacuation zone's been ordered to evacuate. So now's a good time to start thinking about life decisions and what I want to do next. I had it right the first time. Sorry, everybody. There we go. So our mass alert system, right? Curses. We're just going to go through in presentation mode. Our mass alert system, right? We can send out automated message. We can state the evacuation zone that we have on record for that person. How do we get that information about that person? Before time, they can go ahead and register, or even in the event of a situation. Just like you saw the announcements that went out for the Red Cross, right? You can have a number that you text. When you text that number, you get a call back. You can go ahead and put in that information, whether it's through IVR or SMS. As data comes back, as people report in, as whether they're checking about their own welfare status, et cetera, we can start to do some real-time statistics, right? So we can do some hot spots of, you know, is there enough supplies in a particular area? Is there power loss? That information can be surfaced up not only to government officials, but potentially infrastructure providers like Duke Energy or TECO or whomever, to know that an area is particularly impacted during and then after. There's also custom callback features as well, right? So we can have a user dial into H.O.P.E. and actually, Kevin, if you let me borrow your phone here.
Certainly.
Actually,
I got to lock it for you.
Please do.
I can do that.
So using Kevin's phone, what we'll do is we'll dial into H.O.P.E. Right?
Are you planning on evacuating?
Yes.
It seems like Orlando might be the best evacuation zone. Would you like to evacuate to Orlando?
Yes.
The best time, for you to leave, will be October 18th at 4 p.m. It looks like the Best Western has rooms available. Would you like us to connect you?
Yes. Hi, is this the Best Western? All right, in the interest of time, we'll keep moving forward here. So our tech stack, as you saw, is made up of a few different things. Jambonz provides the API that we've primarily showcased with IVR, but again, from an SMS standpoint, easily piggyback on. We built a quick infrastructure using Twilio as our SIP provider and using Google for some of the speech to text and then text to speech. Software logistics team helped with some of the infrastructure pieces as well, as far as building it up and making it something we could do in the last 24 hours. And then we also made use of some external APIs. So Hillsborough County, as well as FEMA, have OpenGov APIs, easily accessible. We tap into those. We also use the Amadeus API. So that's how we knew, hey, go to this particular place. There's hotels available. And actually, from a front-end perspective, again, something that can be prettied up after the fact when you're not trying to do something in 24 hours. But the hotels themselves can be looked up. I got to refresh. There you go. See, we even have a built-in timeout. Brilliant. I can pull up information about a particular area, and then I can actually get all the available hotels pulling from that API. You'll see how it's updating in real time. And then if I click on one of those, it actually builds that information out for me. So all the information you saw is in real time. The Best Western was available, and we can kind of steer people, hey, if everybody's going to Orlando and rooms are getting booked up, maybe you want to go a little bit farther up the road to Gainesville or something like that where there are rooms available. So our timer seems to have stopped. I'm not sure where we are from a 5-minute piece, but I've been talking like lately. Are we good? All right.
Any questions now?
Any questions?
Hey, I think it's super interesting. I think it's a great idea. Are there any features you could foresee, like if you had more than 24 hours, you know, like a feature or two in the future you might want to extend?
Absolutely. You know what, Kevin, here.
Yeah. I know you've been thinking about this a lot.
I've been thinking about this a lot. So there's a lot of things I think we could build into it. One thing is we just went through Hurricane Ian, right? We're sitting up here in Tampa, and it's Monday, and we get the evacuation order on Monday. And it's like, oh, geez, if you've been here long enough, it's like, is this really going to hit? Probably not. I really need to take it serious, but I got a busy week. So what am I going to do? So there's two parts to that, really. The first part is if we can push the time closer to when we would need to evacuate from, like, right where we are right now, we could actually evacuate the people that really, really need to evacuate, and the people that didn't need to evacuate, they could stay at home. That obviously saves money, but more importantly, let's say that in this last event, we were evacuating. We left on Monday, right? It's like, let's get, hurry up, let's get a hotel up in Orlando before somebody else does. Well, you know what? We got a hotel up in Orlando, but somebody in Fort Myers really needed that one. So if we could push towards the last, kind of towards the last minute, when we could evacuate, I think that that really helped. Also, going across I-4, let's say that everybody got the evacuation notice at 8 o'clock in the morning. Everybody heads out at 8 in the morning. Ugh, traffic jam, right? One of the features that you heard as part of our demo here was the best time for you to evacuate might be tomorrow at 4 p.m. we could use some type of ML to be able to figure out based on ways or something like that to figure out that this is the best time for you to go, so you're not clogging up the road and you're also not going ahead and just kind of sitting in traffic forever. So lots of things like that. Another thing that we didn't talk about is our circle of friends. You can register, yes. So we started building the application out there to be able to, and I don't know if we have that in there anywhere. Maybe we do. But before the hurricane, you register a list of phone numbers out there. And when you register that list of phone numbers out there, after the event, you can call up and say, hey, is everybody okay? And just kind of have a mechanism to be able to communicate with the people that are also going through the same thing. So there's lots of different avenues that this could go into, I think.
Awesome. Yeah, thank you so much.
Yep.
Great. Any other questions?
Yeah,
right
here.
I do. Guys, I'm thinking of scalability, right? Hurricanes here, stay in Florida. Well, what are some other events or some other natural disasters that this thing can help? And even on the in the aftermath of it, right? Because it's not just when it happens or before it happens, but what about afterwards, right?
Excellent question. So literally, we've just scratched the surface with what's possible. There is a limitation on what we can use the medium for. It's just how we set it up and point it out for. We picked hurricanes because that's an obvious thing that was easy to glob onto and talk about. But literally, it could be anything. It could be a tornado. It could be the zombie apocalypse. It doesn't matter. I mean, at the end of the day, what really matters is, one, capturing that first set of touch point. And one thing we didn't talk about here, too, is that this system is not dependent upon the internet being available to someone's phone.
That's right.
It's literally across the old system where anyone that can touch tone or even rotary dial, God, I can't remember the name, even those can get into the system and answer the questions. So literally it's a situation where you go back to the lowest common denominator and you apply all that on the back end, which is gonna be someplace in the cloud and safe from that particular event, where people can still be serviced, as well as tying all that together and letting EMS services get out to people that actually need it. And one thing we didn't talk about was also getting to point two, where now we know where those clusters of people are, rather than them have to go door by door in the neighborhood, because as long as people actually register for the system, we would know exactly who stayed and who didn't. And not only that, where they are. So it's no longer a location finding of who might need services, it's knowing I gotta get those five people from that street right there.
Yeah. Even if it's anonymized, we still have a rough idea on where people are, right? So that helps tremendously. Mm-hmm.
Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
Are there any other questions from the audience? All right, I don't see any. Very good work, guys.
Thank you. All right.
Okay, so our next and last group here is the box. Where is the box?